I was really grateful for
to see people sharing, and really grateful to see the passionate actions from around the world. And we're very grateful for Brother Wei Yang and Sister Yachun for their dedications, and we are very appreciate for the everything that happens in the Mannheim school. So really grateful for the Tsuji volunteers to serve and to help people around the world. So we have seen students from Mozambique doing exercise. So it's really great to see them being very energetic. Now we're back to Kaohsiung. We are looking at Sister Dailin, and she has brought 4 students from Mozambique. And for the graphic design team that we received from China. So thank you for graphic design and an editorial team for this very beautiful poster. So Sister Dailin is here, so we're very happy to see everyone. So Sister Dailin is, she's also from Kaohsiung. So Mary Sister had told her that if you ever came back from Mozambique, you always have to come back to see us. So this is why she's paying us a visit. You can see that from promotional material from the past, and you can see from different time has progressed. Here is a video clip we want to show you. So we have seen our associate executive director at the Mozambique's construction for the new school dormitory. So they are building an elementary school. So their welcome ceremony is really like very different, very like more lively, more active. And so the associate executive director has been visiting the site to see how things are going, and now at this point. Sister Dailin has been to New York. They were the design for this video is to using different locations to earlier this year, so they have been there to for the conference.
Empowering women and girls here at the 68th Commission on the Status of Women. Today, 1 in every 10 women is living in extreme poverty.
The conversation about poverty has rarely talked about how it intersects with gender inequality.
Women and girls have a fundamental human right to voice in the decisions that affect their lives.
They also need to celebrate their sons and show their sons what role they play in helping their sisters.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Dino. I am with the Zichi Foundation, and we hope that by the end of this session, we've got more light to shed into what we're doing in Mozambique. Thank you very much.
It's a really great opportunity to be here in New York, specifically here at the United Nations for the CSW 68.
Going back to the issue of equality, at my house, I think it's 50-50. The reason why I'm talking about my house is actually my boss is here, my wife.
My name is Denise. I'm the representative of the City Foundation Mozambique. We are going to share our experience in the past few years, especially after the Cyclone Idai.
In 2019, my country Mozambique was devastated by the biggest cyclone ever.
5 years before, when I was here with CSW, I got the news about our hometown hit by the Cyclone Idai.
It was very heavy and very emotional. I'd never seen something like that. And more than that, my wife was not there.
I was thinking, I want to go back. I'm here, but my heart is with Mozambique.
That created the largest project that we're managing currently. We are building 23 schools and 3,000 houses.
We start, they didn't understand. We lost everything, but we're still alive. And you are not alone. Ciji are with you together in Mozambique. For the girls, the parents rather them to go cook for home or take care of the younger sisters and brothers, and instead they go to school.
I mean, if you look at a person like me, you won't tell that my mother and my father could not read and write. In my country, it's very common that people are not educated. You educate a woman, you have got a better community.
We see a very interesting trend. Every time that we are delivering the keys from the houses, actually we are giving to the women. So it means that, in fact, the head of the home, not the house, of the home is the woman. We need to empower them. We believe that the future, at least in Mozambique, passes by educating women. If you educate a woman, there is a future over there. Thank you very much.
Wow. Is it very inspirational? So we are we're seeing Mrs. Dailin in front of us. So that's her mother. So Sister Dailin's mother is a teacher. That's his younger brother. So the younger brother works in Singapore. We're very grateful to have everyone here. Especially we have four students from Mozambique. They all speak Mandarin as well, and English, and Portuguese. So they are multilingual talent. Everybody has been very busy. she was still like fixing her PowerPoint yesterday, last night. So she turned her PowerPoint in like 1:38 in the morning. Watching them, we have seen that they have a lot of energy. So I'm really happy to see them. We're very grateful for them. We're actually doing exercise with us. So Yes. So they are going to Hualien today and tomorrow, and then we'll present the progress in Mozambique to Master Chen Yan. So the video you are seeing is that we have seen that there's effort for Ciji to push for gender equalities in Mozambique by empowering women, and couple have to work really hard together. And Dino, her husband, has gotten his PhD at age 36, and he is one of the few people in his country that actually obtained the PhD, this high educational level. So he used to work for the president, and because Sister Dailin, he had an opportunity to walk into the poor community to really get in touch with the grassroots and change his life. So there's a lot of stories in Mozambique, and most of the people in Kaohsiung can actually share some of the story because they all know them, but nobody can do better than Sister Dailin. So that's give a round of applause and welcome Sister Dailin to share with us. We are so happy to also have the family come to support her. So this is us in Mozambique. So Master Chen Yan, Abu Master, and everyone, greeting. Welcome with me to fly to Mozambique, which is 16,000 kilometer away. So I got married to someone in Mozambique, but it was it's a big good experience, and I'm very grateful for it. Mozambique, as same as everywhere else, they has this beauty. It also has its sorrows, and per person is like $414. This is number 7 poorest country in the world. So I was very shocked that it has so poor, and they have a lot of 42% of children 5 years younger has suffered in nutrition deficiency, and 99% of children cannot meet the nutrition standards intake for the U.S. table. So one of the county with 340,000 people, but they only have 6 doctors. So this is they have to work with nutritionists. They have worked with many doctors trying to help solve the problem with children's nutritional deficiency. So the 4 students with here, they also came from the county that I just mentioned. So this is the ambulance from one of the village. So my husband, Brother Dino, he wore his first pair of shoes at age 8 years old. And also that's when the first time he saw electricity. He said that if it wasn't because education, I'd probably be riding bicycles, like for a living. So he was very grateful that his brother brought him to the capital of Mozambique, and so to expose him to education, so that had changed his life. So he understand that how important it is to they have education for everyone. So there's a brother Yang brought him to Siji. So he's introduced him to Siji, so he was really, really grateful for that. What happened? He's really happy that they have been accompanying us. So the brother Pan Mingxuan has brought a group of volunteers to Mozambique to support them, and it was really great opportunity. So they have helped train the volunteers to be such certified volunteers. Years ago, even my mom probably doesn't know, so she was really, really wanted to go back to Taiwan because she didn't like the place at the time because it was so poor. But she was lucky that she was introduced to Master Chen Yan, and introduced to Tsuji Master Chenyan, so that had changed her course of life, and she learned that she has to seize the opportunity to really provide something for this community. It was really difficult to start. And she remembered the first time she brought her husband, the Brother Dino, to Tsuji in Taiwan for blessing ceremony. And it was a very short time. Like they could talk to Master Chenyan. Mrs. Dailin was very worried about helping the community in Mozambique because she had seen that the suffering is so great, and it doesn't see the edge, and she doesn't know where to start and how to start. So Master Chenyan look at her and look at Ms. Bardino, tell them that don't worry, just seize the opportunity to really bring the treasure of their spiritual treasure to them. So from the beginning, we have been doing it on the roadside, under the tree, everywhere, every place we can find is our spiritual practice ground. After starting the second year, we were able to have a more permanent location under the mango tree. The local volunteers have done something interesting. Every time when they do something else, when they come back to the mango tree, they treat the mango tree as their jing si hou. So when they come over, they will take off their shoes and walk barefoot and sit under the mango tree. So they cannot have created invisible boundary for their imaginary jing si hou. So that had been a very inspirational gesture, and we have feel empowered and we don't feel alone. This is March 2019, Cyclone Idai is one of the strongest cyclone, tropical storms in the global south. The province of Sofala, where 90% of the roof has been blown away, it's because the disaster damage was so great. But because it was so great, and we have so many people who end up and help, so we're able to make a lot of things happen. A lot of big, well-known volunteer, or like a head of departments, all came over to visit Mozambique. When we walk into the community, there's a lot of water hasn't really completely retreated yet. So I would see a lot of volunteer helping out. And so when we planned the Buddha bathing ceremony, They also have create a medical outreach, like a free clinic for people, local people. A lot of people have told them that they have never seen a doctor in their entire life. So it was, and we have 18 volunteers who made a vow back in 2019 to move down to the province to be a permanent volunteer there. And all 18 of them are still there. They have brought pots, pans, bamboo bank, and master's portrait to that province with them. And they have, over the time, they have recruited over 4,000 volunteers and still continue to serve the community. That girl you have seen on the picture, she's the oldest daughter in the family. And because they're so poor, and she has other brothers and sisters. So the parents told her that, we need your help, so don't go to school anymore. So she had to do housework and farm work to sustain her brother and sister. But the volunteers are trying to bring them back to school. So they provide money and then some necessity for her to be able to in school. And they have built school. And they also, when the school was built, Master Chen Yan has provided Jingsi bathrooms in Portuguese for the local student. So they see Jingsi Bathroom as a school, like a spiritual school. So whenever time, if they have something not making them not happy, or they may run into trouble, they will turn to the Jingsi Bathroom for answers. This is the school they have built. Wow. This is the largest middle school in Mozambique. They have, back then, they had 14 classrooms and 2 bathrooms to hold 6,000 students. Now, they have over 58 school classroom. They're very poor, but they all work really hard. And when they see hope, they really try to hold on to it. And this girl, or this boy, he's like really good. So Angie and Thomas, they are the students from Mozambique. They both work really hard. So this kid has only been in Taiwan for 4 months. He is able to speak Mandarin like this. His name is Thomas. He used to study in Mozambique middle school. They used to suffer for punishment that they don't have computer in their computer classes. So now they're really happy because they have improved a lot their computer skill. They are really happy for the exposure to Siji and then and grateful for Master Zin's guidance. So both of them actually wanted to become Chinese Mandarin teachers. Now, this is NG. This is his name, Lin Anji, and he's from Mozambique. He used to study in the Mozambique middle school. Back then, we only have two bathrooms, but we have 5,000 students. They don't have any choice. The school doesn't have money or resources to build more. And the school also don't have roof. So when there is raining, they have to go home because they can't continue the classroom. So in winter time, in the morning, they have to stay in the sun for a little bit before they can go into the classroom because it's so cold and the condition was really harsh. But they are really grateful for Ziji and Master Qingyan's compassionate actions to help them to be able to go to school. Those two, after the cycling item, they were one of the students who studies in the tent, you know, without a roof, and then to really really trying to study. So we have mentioned Jingsi and Formerson. So they have made a song for Jingsi and Formerson. So they wanted to use music as a medium to spread Dharma. So this is we're grateful for making this song. So they actually wrote a song and practiced within the night. So they're basically saying that, you know, everybody has to do their part to create this harmonious society. I will bow to become part of the movement. So they have, right now they have about 8,031 students, but there's only 1,669 students has textbook. So they have created a store, an event to fundraise to get more book. So they, when they have book study, when they gave them books, and then after the end of the sessions, they say, oh, we can have to take the book back. And then students were like, you know, this is the first time ever that we actually have textbook, and the first time ever somebody can teach us something very valuable. And we please keep the book. So they were really grateful. So and then they don't let them keep the book. So Currently, they have about 34 people grouped of teachers, principals, and faculty in Ziji, Hualien, for training, just to learn how to run school and then to have exchange. They really, really want to change their country. They really wanted to learn how to be mindful and to have positive energies and then in their education system. So they really, really happy they are learning this in Ziji right now. So this is a auspicious common affinity. We're grateful to have them to able to see the beauty of Ziji. And this year when the associate directors to bring a lot of shoes that was donated from Taiwan. She said that she forgot to pay more attention because she's been living there so long, so she got kind of used to it. So she didn't realize that how happy they are when they try on the shoes, because for many of them, that's the first pair of shoes they have in their life. And the students wake up every morning, get really, really excited to be able to put on their shoes and to go to school. This is what happens in 2019. This is what the community looks like. So, Mustang has told the city volunteers that, you know, we have to provide them ways to survive, to sustain themselves. So Ziji has provided seeds and also create a vocational school to help them to teach them some surviving working skills. So in June this year, Ziji has provided to build a Dai village for them to stay in. So this is the event where the opening for the vocational school. So they have teach Excel, they have teach different base skills for them to be able to work. So that's a comparison between 2019 and 2024. And that's how Winfang hand cities to a village that was a permanent village that was built. So the video was to welcome Ziji volunteers to So they basically made a video to welcome Master Chen Yan to Mozambique. So the bicycle was the best car, best vehicle they have. So from nothing to they are able to create to create a future for themselves. So they are making their cornstarch. So they were hopeless. They were uncertain in their future. Now the village has become very lively, and then there's hope everywhere. And it smiles. They see their future in their hands. Okay. There's 130 households are able to obtain bicycle. They were really, really happy. In 2019, the city volunteer had nothing but a determined heart to start the relief works in Mozambique. So we're really, really grateful for love from everyone. Thank you, everyone, for all your hard work. We were able to create so much miracles in Mozambique. We have over 6,000 trees. Please help us to we're gonna have Beizhu, his name is Beizhu, who is here. They live outside the village, so that they weren't able to be included in the Dai village. But he also still studied very hard. So his name is Beizhu, so he's really touching to be here. He's very grateful for Tsuji's help. So, because they were able to live in the kind of house they never thought they could be lived in. And they used to be really, really scared of all the cyclone. Now they don't really have to worry about. Is it scholarship? So he was, they barely have any clothes, and then he was really grateful for Tsuji able to provide him with the uniform and also provide him a scholarship to further his education. So we welcome all the students together and then to truly show their appreciation. They have come up with a song last night, a song that they created last night for everyone. Hello, brothers and sisters. We want to sing a song for you to show the appreciation for all the love you gave. The lyrics basically says that we're so grateful for the love Fan Siqi has always been there. They're really shy, but they're really trying their best.
Oh, yeah,
Thank you. I'm so grateful. So what I'm saying is that, you know, to understand Chinese, you have to really learn how to spread Dharma. So they are doing a sign language performance from a verse of Sutra, Infinite Meaning. Oh wow. Grateful, very grateful. So we'll very grateful that we have learned to be self-reliant. So when we, even though we're not in Africa, that we would still be able to endure all the difficult time. So she has been married to Mozambique for 16 years. 16 years. It's not easy to accomplish this much in 16 years. These are the best students selected by the principal. So they're like elite, top of this class. So they can actually understand when all the volunteers speak Chinese. So they usually get complaint from their teacher that they study so hard and they don't sleep. So they have about 15 classmates came with them to Taiwan to study. During the volunteer assembly, I think on Monday, so the university's principal was sharing about Mozambique students. We're really inspired and very happy that we have participated in the relief work in Mozambique. It's very. Brother Yaming has recruited a lot of volunteers. I think the best volunteer he has recruited is the Dailin. So he was helping Mozambique so much. Really grateful to see how they were able to change courses for the students. Volunteer in Fangchuan, were really happy and appreciate that Sister Dailin brought Buddha's Dharma to Mozambique. It's Frontier provide feedback saying that these Sister Dailin is like a superwoman, brought so much power, so much energy, all the positivities to Mozambique. And then we were so shocked how these kids were so happy with the first shoes they have. And compared to, we only always to think about what kind of which pair of shoes we want to wear. So we're really grateful to have them to be here. Thank you very much. Okay, please be seated. I had to go really fast. We ran over time. So please support the Jinx's product. Well, very. So next week, Suji Middle School. Superintendent will come visit, come sharing. I'm very grateful. So please come see us every Wednesday. Thank you so much.